I'm glad to be back with you for the second part of the hands-on. In the first part, with Dominique, you have been able to connect your smartphone to the BLE peer-to-peer server application running on STM32WBA. But for time being, we have not been able to exchange some data. In the second part of this hands-on session, we will now implement a BLE profile, peer-to-peer profile, being able to exchange data between smartphone and Nucleo board. So let's start together. To start the second part, here are the prerequisites. I will not spend time on it as this hands-on 2 is a follow-up of the hands-on 1, so there is nothing new here. What we will do in this second part of the hands-on? With Dominique, you have been able to connect to your smartphone. You connect, disconnect, advertise again, and connect. In this part, we will now see how to create a custom service to be able to exchange data between STM32WBA, peer-to-peer server firmware, and smartphone. So we will enhance your existing application. So please keep your hands-on one open on your laptop because this is a follow-up. We'll simply enhance the hands-on one. So as a reminder, at first, this is what you did with hands-on one. You create a server that wants to share data. This is my server. You want to share data. Then in front of my server, I have a client, typically a smartphone, that is looking for data. So this is why the server is advertising to say, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. And the client on smartphone side is looking for data and so scanning is scanning and establishing connection. So this is how we define this client server architecture for connection. Now we need to access data. How to access data? This is the purpose of attribute table. This is what we call ATT. ATT define a way to access data. It defines the notion of service, characteristic, and data. And everything is included inside what we call a profile. What is a Bluetooth Low Energy Profile? Most probably you already heard about Bluetooth Low Energy Profile. What is it? A Bluetooth Low Energy Profile, a profile includes one or more services. Each service can handle one or more characteristics. Then each characteristic is having different properties. Three main characteristic properties are read, write, notify. Each service or characteristic is defined by a unique ID. This unique ID is having two formats. Either it is a 16-bit unique ID. In this case, we are talking about standard unique ID, standard profile, standard service defined by the Bluetooth SIG Alliance, or it can be a proprietary profile, and in this case, unique ID are 128 bits, and this is the case of our here peer-to-peer server. We will work on it today. A standard profile ID are defined by the Bluetooth SIG. That means that it ensures interoperability. What is the main difference between standard and proprietary profile? If you use a standard profile, everything is defined by the SIG Alliance. The SIG Alliance defines everything for this profile. Role, requirement, and the structure of the attribute table, including the different unique ID. This is the case, for example, of the Earth rate service. That means that any smartphone application implementing the Earth rate will be able to discuss with any device implementing Earth rate service. In case of proprietary profile, this is the choice of a huge majority of our customers. Here you can do what you want. Anyway, it will require your own app to be able to communicate. Indeed, we are talking here about proprietary profile. That means that if you want to discuss with a smartphone, you need an application that implements the same profile. Otherwise, you will not be able to communicate or to translate data. You will just see raw data. As an example, here for our peer-to-peer server, peer-to-peer server, we will define some specific unique ID. Here on our STBLE Toolbox smartphone application, which implement this BLE peer-to-peer server proprietary profile. That means that when we will connect to a device implementing this, our STBLE Toolbox app will automatically recognize the specific unique ID for the peer-to-peer server and will be able to display a nice logo. And this is the same for the characteristic logo. Instead of displaying the two characteristics for LED and button, thanks to the unique ID that will be recognized by the STBLE Toolbox, we are able to display nice logo. At this stage, I would say now it's time to practice and to activate service and characteristic for this peer-to-peer server profile into our existing code. So we are back with the code of the Hanson one, and we will reopen the .ioc to select BLE application and service and select one service. Indeed, our BLE peer-to-peer server contains one service with two characteristics. One service which is defined later with a specific unique ID, we will come back on it, and then one characteristic for the LED to toggle the LED from the smartphone, and one characteristic for the switch button. When we will press the button on the Nucleo board, we will use this characteristic to send a notification to the smartphone. So let's go back to Cube IDE. Using Cube IDE, this is the status of the hands-on one you did with Dominique in previous video. Just open back the .ioc file. Then in the software component, we will select STM32WPAA. This is already the one that you activated during hands-on one. And we will go into the BLE application and service tab, and we will define one service. As soon as we created this with this, we added one service, a new tab appear named service one. And we will now fill this service one configuration. So let's now set and configure our service one. To configure our service one, we need to first click on the service one tab here and configure as per the definition of our peer-to-peer server profile. Peer-to-peer server profile is more or less a specification. This is a document. And we need to follow exactly how it is defined. So first, we need to configure the unique ID. Unique ID, as said, proprietary profile, so 128 bits. Here, we will simply enter a short unique ID, FE40. You may think that, okay, you told us that a proprietary profile is 128 bits, whereas here we are entering only 4 bytes. Don't worry, the application code will happen the remaining 112 bits. The ID here is to avoid typing the whole unique ID. Then we need to give a name to our service. We will call it peer-to-peer server. Please, I'd advise you to use exactly the same name as per what I'm sharing currently on this screen, because the name you will set here for service long name and service short name are the one used for code generation. Of course, you are free to modify the code, but just be aware that if you modify this name, the function name, file name will be different, and you will not be able to copy paste the code after code generation directly from the cheat sheet. So you will need to adapt. If you want simply to copy paste the code, please use exactly this name with respect to the uppercase and lowercase. So this is done. So we will define unique ID FE40, service name. Then this service handle two characteristics, one for LED, one for the switch. So now let's enter the LED characteristic. We need to configure the LED characteristic as per definition of the BLE peer-to-peer server. This case, the unique ID is FE41. This is same for the characteristic long name and short name as per what I said for the service name. Please use exactly this name, my_led_char. And let's see in uppercase for the short name, important for code generation. Then the length, this is the length of our characteristic. We say 2 bytes. Why 2 bytes? Because this is the definition here of the characteristic. As well, in this documentation, the length characteristic is defined as variable. This is not mandatory, but we should define as per the BLE profile definition. So variable. Our LED characteristic is having 2 properties. One is the read properties, because our smartphone must be able to read the value of the characteristic and read the status of the LED. And it is write with response. Indeed, our smartphone must be able to toggle the LED by writing into this characteristic. As well, we will deactivate here the application response. This is not needed here. Once done, we will now do the same for the second characteristic, which is the button characteristic. So this time we have a new unique ID for this characteristic, FE42, name, one more time. I'm repeating myself, but we need to follow exactly this name, my_switch_char, and short name, switch_c, uppercase. Length is as well 2 for this characteristic, and the length characteristic is variable. This time, in terms of properties, characteristic properties, we will only activate the notification, notify. Here, the purpose of notify is that if that characteristic is having a notify characteristic, that means that the smartphone can register to notification. And each time we will write into this characteristic, the smartphone will be notified of a characteristic change. And this is exactly what we want for this BLE peer-to-peer server. What we want is that when we press the button, we want a notification to be received on smartphone side. And same as for LED, we will deactivate application response. Once we done this, we configure the service, we configure the two characteristics, we are done. Profile creation is over. It's time to move to code generation. To move to this code generation, now you know the procedure. On CubeID, everything is now completed. We will simply click on the wheel here to generate the code. And it should generate all the code related to our BLE peer-to-peer server. And this time, we have all the profile defined. That means that we have the definition of the service and the definition of the characteristic. So let's wait a few seconds to get the code fully generated. Here we are. We are done. Here now we have the full code generated. Now this is not enough. Remember, we have to manage those characteristics. Everything is in place, but we need to write, we need to read those characteristics and to send notification on button press. And this is part of the user application. And this is what we will do now. And for this, we will use the cheat sheet code that you already use for Hanzon 1. But this time, we will click on Hanzon 2 and we will apply the modified code that are described here. So let's move forward. To summarize, where do we stand currently? We perform the hardware configuration. We configure BLE parameters. We created the profile, service, characteristic. We generate code. And now I say it's time to move to application code. At first, we will remove what we have done with Dominic in hands-on session 1. Why? Currently, the code that was shared during hands-on 1 was accessing BLE stack, APIs, ACI level. This is okay and this is fine, but Cubemx generated new code with some abstraction layer, higher abstraction layer that can do the same in one line. So if we can do the same in one line, why to not do it? It will ease your development and software level. And for this, we have this function, gap peripheral, and we set one parameter to state, okay, start advertising. And this is what we will do now. So for this, we will use the cheat sheet code. Simply go to appble.c. So at the place where we put all the code in hands-on one, we will simply replace this with this new line copied from the cheat sheet. And we will do the same when receiving a disconnection complete. When we receive the disconnection complete, we want to start advertising again to be discoverable again to accept a new connection. One more time, starting an advertising is an application decision. This is not automatic. Second part, we want to toggle the pin. When the smartphone we write into the characteristic, we want to toggle the pin. For this, we will go in app folder, BLE peer-to-peer server app.c. Let's open it. Each time the smartphone will write into the LED characteristic, we will receive this kind of notification event. So here we will not take care of the status of the LED. We will simply toggle the LED. Each time the client will write into the LED characteristic, we will toggle the LED, whatever the value. This is not the purpose of this hands-on. This purpose is to interact with LED. We need now to handle the button. For the button, we will add a sequencer. What is a sequencer? Inside our BLE Cube firmware code example, we offer the possibility to add some sequencer. A sequencer is a simple way. This is not a RTOS, this is not a real-time system, but we have this sequencer that allows to define some tasks. And we will define a task for our button. For this, we will need to define a new task ID to define a new task. Then we will register this task. And to register this task, we will register this task and associate a callback for this function. Here, the callback will be sending a notification to the client. Of course, we need to schedule this task. And when will we schedule this task? It's time end user will press the button, basically inside IRQ. And this is what we will do now. So I'm coming back to Cube IDE and my cheat sheet code. So at first, I need to define my new task. For this, I will go in core include in appconf.h file. And I will look for the task definition to ease finding. You can look directly from this comment, task ID. So I will simply copy the definition and add my new task. Once done, I need to register a callback to my task. For this, I will open the file peer-to-peer server app.c and I will manage this register the task at the end of the initialization. once everything is initialized, I know I can register this callback sending notification to my task button. This function is already generated by Cubemix. This function is already present. This is a function used to send notification. And this is exactly what we want to achieve. Now, when will we schedule our task? We will simply schedule our task when someone will press the button. For this, we will simply overwrite the weak function for the GPIO IRQ link to the GPIO button one pin. So this is done in app entry.c at the end of the file. So by default, this callback is a weak function. We are simply overwriting this weak function. Now we are almost done for this button. What is missing is to send some data into our notification, because currently we are sending notification, but empty notification. To send some data, we will do this into peer-to-peer server app.c. I said this function is here. This function is already generated. We will simply add few lines here from cheat sheet code to add some data. And we are done. Here, our task button is fully completed. We are now ready to build the code, flash, and run, and test our application. So let's first build the code by clicking on this hammer icon. So it may take few minutes. During this time, I can connect my WBA5 Nucleo board to my laptop. And one more time, we will use the embed ST-Link probe to flash and debug. So compilation is now okay with zero error and zero warning. Let's run our application, flash and run. So flash still ongoing, download verified successfully, I'm done. Let's check together now if everything is fine. And first, see the Nucleo board. On our Nucleo board, we can see that firmware is flash, and by default, we have two LED already activated. Now we can open our smartphone, activate STBLE toolbox application. It starts scanning. Now I can discover my peer-to-peer server. I can connect to it. As you can see now, compared to the hands-on session number one that you did with Dominique in previous video, we can see that we have an additional service, which is the peer-to-peer server. I can see here that my STBLE toolbox smartphone application recognizes this service. I will open this service and it recognizes as well, thanks to the unique ID, it can display nice icon for LED and button because it recognizes unique ID. Now, if I toggle the LED using on smartphone side, I can see the LED toggling on my Nucleo board. So this is expected. Here, the status on smartphone is not aligned with the status on the Nucleo board, but let's say it is expected because in the application code we add, we simply toggle the LED without taking care of their current status. On the other way, now, if I push a button on B1 button, I can see that I'm receiving on my smartphone a notification. So that means that here, starting from scratch, we have been able to create a peer-to-peer server, but it can be any proprietary profile. We are able to communicate starting from scratch from WBA embedded firmware through our BLE proprietary profile with a smartphone, and we can do this in both directions. That means that we have everything in place to develop advanced BLE application. I hope this session has been useful for you. This can be replicated, of course, using your own profile and own characteristic, all services. You can add what you want, but here we succeed together to build this BLE application. So thank you for your attention. Let's now summarize briefly our hands-on session by some takeaways. You have been able to build from scratch a Bluetooth low energy application in few clicks. You have been able to start from scratch, selecting the right target using Cube IDE, CubeMX. We selected STM32WBA5 target. On top of this, we have been able to build a full BLE proprietary profile, customizing some service, customizing advertising data, customizing characteristics. And then we have been able to add few lines of code to make connection possible with the smartphone and exchange some data with the smartphone in both directions. And this is typically what a Bluetooth low energy application is doing. And this is most probably what your application will have to do. And as you've seen, in few clicks, we have been able to generate a full Bluetooth low energy application. So I would say that in terms of firmware, we are done. Now I will give the floor to my hardware colleague, Laurent, that will talk about how to optimize your PCB to get the best RF performance and power performance. And he will also give you some words about RF and Bluetooth certification. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned.